We know the situation in many households here in the Philippines, specifically here in Metro Manila. We have a lot of crowded houses, right? Communities, depressed communities as well. And then, of course, the next question is, where do they go in order to somehow mitigate that situation? Because we know that crowding is a problem when it comes to COVID-19 transmission.
Yeah, you're right, Christian. The urban poor areas, 9 square meters for 5 people, that's less than 2 square meters per person. It's better for them to go out, get sunshine and air. And they could be given, just like what Chuchu did after Yolanda, cash for work. And they can do urban farming, clean up the steros, make sidewalks, bicycle lanes, plant. Plant trees along waterways, along sidewalks. And cash for work. They can clean their surroundings and so on. Mm. And open spaces are the lungs of the city. Metro Manila doesn't have enough open space. If compare Metro Manila to the human body, the open spaces are the lungs of the city. Mm. And then the roads and waterways are the arteries of the city. And the major activity centers, like central business districts, they are the heart of the city. So if you compare it, our Metro Manila needs a heart transplant, a heart bypass, and a lung transfer. We don't have enough open spaces in Metro Manila.
Okay.
And you were talking about hospitals. With our 107 million population, we need more than 5,000 hospitals. At the moment, we only have 1,500 hospitals. That's why at Palafox, we proposed, we donated designs for COVID centers to convert basketball courts to COVID centers to decongest the hospitals.
Okay. Now, of course, we know that we cannot put people on lockdown forever, especially in their houses, given the situations, right? And as you mentioned, there are not enough open spaces in Metro Manila. But do you think this should be a priority, urban infrastructure, as far as LGUs are concerned? Because you know that they have limited resources as well.
Yeah, these are low-cost, we call it tactical urbanism. It can be done during the pandemic. The epicenter of a pandemic in Europe is Milan. Right now, Milan, they're doing widening sidewalks and making bicycle lanes. And doing low-cost, quick action, maybe for the next 18 months, we can do tactical urbanism, guerrilla urbanism, and infrastructure. It can be done even on a barangay level. And we have, I heard, 8,000 hectares of vacant land in Metro Manila. We can do urban farming, urban gardens. And many properties, including governmental offices, they have so much idle land. After the OPEC oil crisis of 1973, many cities in the world, including New York, from pavement to parks like Times Square, they widened their sidewalk, put bicycle lanes. And after 1973 oil crisis, it has been recognized that walking and cycling bicycles are the first two modes of transportation. And the principle is those who have less in wheels, they should have more in roads. And we've been planning and designing healthy cities. The road cross-section should be 1/3 for people, pedestrians and cyclists, bicycles, 1/3 for trees and landscaping. It takes about 10 trees to recover the oxygen of the carbon monoxide per car, and only 1/3 for moving traffic vehicles. This is our opportunity to correct our urban development and urban planning. Urban plans have been put forward after the open oil crisis, like public transit. Mm.
And so far, are you seeing enough efforts on the part of local government units, for example, specifically here in Metro Manila, toward this direction? We know that there are existing parks, but many of them need improvement. How about, for example, the establishment of mini parks? And we're also hearing suggestions or proposals to come up with streets devoted to outdoor dining. Are these good ideas, especially at this time?
Yeah. Yes, Christian. In fact, our calculations at Palafox is restaurants now should be 30% kitchen, 20% indoor dining, 50% alfresco dining, outdoor dining. And parks and open space, even Quezon City has the most number of parks. So I've been talking to Mayor Joy Belmonte, invited us for a discussion to talk about parks, bicycle lanes, and urban agriculture for Quezon City. And Quezon City has the most number of parks. I was talking also to Secretary Rosimato of DNR. So Gina Lopez at ABS-CBN Foundation, they were our clients for La Mesa Eco Park. Because La Mesa Eco Park can be part of the lungs of the city. And the Parks and Wildlife, meaning Aquino Park, DNR is controlling that. It could be part of the system. In Boston, Cambridge, what they did was they call it a Boston Netflix. All the open spaces system are interconnected by walking path, jogging path, and bicycle lane, interconnected. I think Quezon City has most open spaces in Metro Manila, and a lot of vacant lots also. So they're now starting urban agriculture. And also even rooftop gardens should be done because we don't have open spaces. Singapore has 45% open space. Mm. And there are cluster buildings in Singapore, 100% open space. But even the rooftop will make gardens. So the footprint of the buildings, they recover the open spaces by putting in rooftops with rainwater harvesting as well. So this is now the opportunity to make connections. In fact, what we're doing at Palafox, we take pictures of the uglification of our cities and do architectural perspective, urban design perspective, how they should look better, and I call them postcards from the future. Mm-hmm. This can be implemented, low-cost, immediate action. And every barangay can do that.
Mm-hmm. So you're talking of practical urbanism, right? But when it comes to costs, is it expensive?
No, it's low-cost. Unlike the big ticket items, like putting up, let's say, creeks should have 3.5 meter setback, and you could have linear parks. Our proposals, recommendations for so many decades already for passing river, 10 meter setback, and Manila Bay or Bay Walk, Laguna Lakefront, so we can interconnect with linear parks our fragmented metropolis. Mm-hmm. It can be done quickly. We have 44,000 barangays in the country. 1,600 cities and municipalities, they can do it without depending on national government.
Mm. But of course, people still need to observe the minimum health standards whenever they go out, right? And I think it's important to point out, yesterday there was this webinar or press conference by medical frontliners, and they mentioned a very important data there, that outdoor open air or open spaces actually lead to 95% reduction in terms of the risk of transmission for COVID-19. But of course, people also need to make sure that they are also observing the other measures. Now finally, Architect Palafox, are you seeing enough effort on the part of LGUs at this time toward establishing, let's say, what you call practical urbanism?
Practical urbanism, or guerrilla urbanism. We had two Sundays of discussions already with Mayor Belmonte and her team, and the doctors, Dr. Dance, Dr. Santos, and Dr. Alfonso. They are recommending this. In fact, open spaces to heal those who are infected was proposed by Hippocrates, 400 BC. Then Florence Nightingale, the famous nurse. Hospitals that have windows with natural light and ventilation, patients recover quicker than hospitals without windows. So 400 years before Christ, it was done. And architects like Le Corbusier, they encouraged that even condominiums, multifamily condominiums, they should have natural light and ventilation. So all architecture now should be like healthcare facilities. And yes, for us architects, it's a challenge to make them more aesthetically pleasing. Mm-hmm. I agree with the doctors, and I said, 400 years BC, Hippocrates said that, and Florence Nightingale. And after epidemics in Europe, they increased their open spaces, made cities walkable. In fact, we're designing healthy cities. Ideally, we adults, we should walk 10,000 steps a day. That's 7 kilometers. In Makati, where I stay and work, I only walk 2,000 steps a day. Even in July, August, in Europe or Manhattan, I can walk 14 kilometers a day because they have nice sidewalks. Mm. Even these expensive bridges, I'd rather have pedestrian bicycle bridges across Pasig River, San Juan River, Marikina River, and all the waterways, 800 meters apart. when we were designing Rockwell 1992, a survey was done. We Metro Manilans, we walk only 400 meters because we didn't have good sidewalks. We have sidewalks with open manholes and so on. So the tactical urbanism or guerrilla urbanism, which progressive peoples in the world are doing it right now, let's take advantage of the pandemic to correct all of this before cars come back.
Okay.
And pocket parks also, again, from pavement to parks. Most progressive countries are doing that now.
Okay. Architect Palafox, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Thank you. It's a pleasure. And thank you for allowing me the opportunity to share. Thank you, Christian.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.